వేదిక పైన ఉన్న మహానుభావులు, వేదిక ముంద ఉన్న రేపటి భారతదేశం, మీ అందరికీ నా వందనములు. శ్రీ కనక దుర్గా అమ్మవారి సన్నిధిలో పవిత్ర కృష్ణా గోదావరి సంగములో జరుగుతున్న ఈ జాతీయ మహిళ సంసదులో పాల్గొంటేదానికి సంతోషమని చెప్తే చాలా తక్కువ. ఇది నా సౌభాగ్యమని నేను అనుకుంటున్నాను. త్యాగరాజస్వామి పాటలు చెప్పారు, ఎంత భాగ్యము మా పాల కలిగితివి. అదే నేను కూడా ఇప్పుడు ఈ సంసదలో చెప్పగలుగుతున్నాను. ద విషన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ నేషనల్ విమెన్స్ పార్లమెంట్ సేస్ ఇట్ ఆల్, టు ప్రొవైడ్ ఎ ప్లాట్ఫామ్ దట్ విల్ ఎనేబుల్ అండ్ ఎన్కరేజ్ ది సోషల్, పొలిటికల్ అండ్ ఎకనామిక్ ఎంపవర్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ విమెన్ ఇన్ ఆల్ స్టార్టప్ ఆఫ్ సొసైటీ. We all talk of empowerment. What exactly is this empowerment all about? In fact, empowerment is, please I underline this word, intentional, ongoing process involving mutual respect, critical reflection, caring and group participation, through which people lacking an equal share of resources gain greater access to and control over these resources. It is in fact gaining mastery over one's own life. As you continue your deliberations, let me stress on the enormous potential that you have to bring about a radical change in the welfare of women. The perception of male domination in certain professions is a thing of the past. Inequality is slowly but steadily vanishing into thin air. But all of us have the responsibility to work towards totally eliminating it. The evidence is overwhelming across the globe that women's empowerment is a powerful force for economic growth, social and political stability, and sustainable peace. We must always remember the word yatra naryastu pujyante ramante tatra devata. Where women are worshipped, there the gods rejoice. In fact, all the speakers here have spoken about women empowerment before me, but I for one can claim that I am really practicing women empowerment, because I probably am the only one who has a Lakshmi in his name. My name is Lakshmi Narasimhan. None of these other speakers have had that benefit, so I can claim to be the most volatile of the women empowerment theory. I believe it is important to spread the word about the immense impact women are having in political, business and economic spheres. Women are becoming the leaders of today, and for their say as decision makers are visible. By being empowered, women must also set the stage for the leaders of tomorrow by becoming role models for young women and girls worldwide. As we have seen on this dais today, we have role models in the form of various speakers, including the Honorable Justice Srimati Rohini, Sagarika, Alka and Bamini, of course. Still, we need policies for long-term security that are designed by women, focused on women and executed by women. At the same time, let us not forget that the policies are executed not at the expense of men or instead of men, but alongside and with men. This is most important. We must end the gender inequality, and to do this, we need everyone's involvement. The National Women's Parliament is a first and an exceptional initiative to achieve the goal where women from all walks of life are brought on to a common platform, probably a campaign of its kind. We should try to mobilize as many leaders as possible to be advocates for bringing about a change. And to achieve this goal, we should not just end with today, talking today and bringing out a leaflet, but try and make it tangible and practical, and we need to practice it in our day-to-day lives. Anyway, it is not the word empowerment that is important here. It is the idea and the ambition behind it, because not all women have received the same rights. Both men and women should feel free to be sensitive. Both men and women should feel free to be strong. It is time that we perceive gender on a spectrum instead of two sets of opposing ideas. If we stop defining each other by what we are not and start defining ourselves by who we are, we can all be free and enjoy freedom. I want men to take up this mantle so that their daughters, their sisters, mothers can be free from prejudice. In fact, the basic responsibility of women empowerment lies in us, the men. And I appeal to all the men in this gathering, please take this upon us on a mission mode. As Chandrababu Naidu Garu has taken this whole National Women's Parliament on a mission mode, we men must now do this in our day-to-day life. The greatest gift of any individual is abhaya, or fearlessness, not merely bodily courage, but absence of fear from the mind. There is no chance for the welfare of the world unless the condition of women is improved. It is not possible for a bird to fly on one wing. Woman is the builder and molder of this nation's destiny. Though delicate, she has a heart stronger and bolder than that of man. She is the supreme inspiration for our onward march. Annamacharya, the famous music composer, has in one of his songs said, "Enta matramuna yavaru telichina." That is, he says, "O Lord, your devotees visualize you in many ways." So also, I would like to say that women are multifaceted. A woman alone can be a Dhairya Lakshmi, can be a Dhana Lakshmi, can be a Dhana Lakshmi, can be a Vijaya Lakshmi, can be a Shanta Lakshmi, can be a Abhaya Lakshmi, can be a Graha Lakshmi, can be a Mahalakshmi, and so on. I can keep on enumerating any number of qualities of the woman. And that is the greatness of a woman. Hence, I would like men and women to recognize this facet. I would also appeal to all to feel proud when a girl child comes into the family. I would use this forum to, apart from appealing to the very elegant and enabled crowd here, to the rural masses, to the women in the rural areas and in all over the country and the world, that please feel proud when a girl child arrives into your family. The first, because it is an arrival of a Mahalakshmi. And when a girl gets married into a family, I always say, here comes your Graha Lakshmi. I mean, she represents everything, and that is the recognition that I think we need to give her on her birth. And as it is said, Karamule Lakshmi, Kale Madhye Saraswati, Karagre Gauri Stita. So you find the central theme in all this is Saraswati. Saraswati resides between Lakshmi and Gauri. And education is the most important thing. We need to educate the girl child. From birth onwards and from every stage, it is the mother's duty, it is the parent's duty, both the mother and the father, to ensure that the girl child receives education. I mean, as much education or more education than the boy child. After all, when a boy is educated, he becomes a mere wage earner. But when a girl is educated, the entire family gets educated. So this education part of it is something which we need to really focus upon in terms of the girls. And education, when it is holistic, builds in value systems, promotes a healthy citizenry. Let the girl child fulfill her dream. Parents must, from childhood, teach their son to respect the girl child. This is very important. The value of a sister and thereby a girl child must be ingrained from childhood, and that is the duty of parents if we want to have a clean society. The simple thing that goes on, phoolon ka taron ka sabka kehna hai, ek hazaron mein meri behna hai, sari umar hame sang rehna hai. This is not just one line of a song. This is what I think the boys must be taught from the very early childhood by their parents. And if this is taught, they will learn the importance of women. I mean, one could be a sister, one could become a spouse, one could become a mother, one could be a mother-in-law. And now, when we talk of heritage, what is the heritage? When you have Raksha Bandhan, why is the Raksha Bandhan done? Here is a girl who is trusting herself in your hands by trying that Raksha Bandhan in you. She says, "Meri raksha karna aapka kartavya hai, aapka duty hai." And this is the importance of this. There is no use of just tying number of raksha bandhans and then saying, "Well, I have done raksha bandhan." It is a sacred pledge that you are giving to the girl at that point of time when you do a Raksha Bandhan. I for one feel, while women should demand their right to be empowered, men have the greatest role in facilitating that. If it is not something you are giving as dhana, please remember, men, it is not a dhanam that you are giving to the woman by giving her empowerment or by giving her education or giving her power. It is something sharing. Sharing is caring and caring is sharing. Remember that. It is a respect and love you are showing for your mother, for your daughter, for your spouse. And there is also, just as Honorable Justice Rohini Madam is here, I would like to plead, ma'am, I think there is a definite need for strengthening the legal process if we have to get women their due time and ensure crime against women. I think the legal process must be a time-bound one, and the trial should end on a fast-track court, preferably within 4 weeks, and exemplary punishment must be meted out to those who indulge in crime against women. Unless